machines, they use G-code. Mm-hmm. It is a movement. What is doing the machine? It is move, because I think it's open, the turtle stitch. Turtle stitch. So maybe you can install it on your computer and see if you can use the here we open it. Here you see a panel where you can see the different files. The first thing is that I will go to the Kingston USB and I will copy these to desktop. Yes, I copy this to the desktop. And now I can go to the editor.
But which did you, are you going to open? Which file is it?
I will try to open.
You,
I'm not sure if it will open.
So which one, the Illustrator or the...
It will not open Illustrator, one.
So you said, so what was the point of that?
Because in case that it cannot open either the SVG, then somebody will use the Illustrator file to export it as image, because you need image in the end.
Okay.
So this, in the beginning, the program opens with an interface where you can see file, the hoop, the size of the artwork. This is important that we define it from the beginning. Because if not, imagine that we will be the scale will be lost, and then you design something that the distance is 2 millimeter because you designed it correctly. But then, if the hoop is not correct, it will scale automatically, and you will lose this distance. So it is important that you define the hoop from the beginning. And in our case, here you see many hoops because this program can be used in all the embroidery machines. Like RhinoCam, you export for, like Cura, you export for pin and hoop. It is the Janom M1 240 by 200 horizontal in standard 2. Yeah? Then we make the hoop. It was this already, it's fine. And then the third step, once we did this in the editor, we launch the studio. So in the studio is where it's the interface like Photoshop. Mm-hmm. So here is our studio where we will create our stitches. And again, I will go to the hoop size and make sure that the hoop is the one that is the one that I will use. Sometimes it loses it. That's why I'm saying. So that's okay. And then image, import, and if we are lucky, it will read the SVG. All files, you see here? It reads BEMP, it reads EMF, GIF, JPEG, PNG, TIFF. Okay, so it doesn't read SVG. We need to transform the SVG or the Illustrator file to one of these file formats. Obviously, the magic wand, you can say create an outline or create an embroidery like figure. Line, fill it, randomly fill it, and this is carving, which I never used. So in this case, what we want is we want to go like
by
this.
Points.
We don't want to go like that. We don't want to go like that. So here we choose the first, which is the outline. And now we can define how are the steps of the machine, like each stitch. Here, you can say, I want each of this, the minimum to be 2 millimeter and the maximum also to be 2 millimeter, so that it's all even. And then we can select this. So here, we see that there is a problem.
the weather.
What's the weather?
No. No, sorry, we're trying a problem. Not working.
So you see that the size, the thickness of the line and the resolution that was exported is making it very pixelated, which is bad because we would need to have a thicker line. And I can do that, but let's try it. Now that I selected everything, and here you can select similar so that it selects all of the thing, like in Photoshop, they select all together. I can right click and generate stitches. And then it is the generator, like the RhinoCam, that calculates the path that it will trace everything. In the meantime, while it is calculating, go to 3D. And see what it does, and it does it very badly, you see? Because the pixels, they were so small that it didn't understand that this was a line.
Okay.
So this, ciao, we don't want you. And you can write down that this happened.
Okay.
This every time, the machine will do click, click, crack, crack, crack. So it will cut every time and create a stitch. It's like
so create points instead of lines.
The machine will break. Yes. So let's try again with the. Here, what's happening? It's okay. File export selected as EF.
Yep.
It's good. So, okay. It's good. At least save the settings. Okay. Image import and this open. Yes, we scaled the fit, and now you see that the pixels are a lot better. Let's see, magic wand, continuous outline. The jumping stitches are 2x2. I click here, up, and now right click. Generate stitches. So still it didn't understand it as a one, which is a problem. You see that there is a cutting thing here. And what I can do, we don't want this. So this we need to delete. And we don't want that. We don't want all these cutting things. It automatically does that. You always need to interfere in the stitches. And delete that. Delete this. Delete that. And delete. So now here you see in 3D the stitches, you see? And we can view, so I will save, here I can go again, and this one, and this one. Why there is a cut? I need to join them. I will group them all group. Yeah. And then I will compile them, save them in the folder of Embert. Here, spiral speaker, new, guardar. And now it will open here. Here, we can view and shoe simulator. So it will show us, and you can put the speed less, play. You see, it does this, and then it does that. So we don't want this. We want to close this. Go here and split join. Split.
How did you do that?
Right click.
Simulate.
View simulate. Separate all items. Here, you have this item, this item, and this item. This item. Stitches. This item. Right click. Reverse stitches. And now, if I join this here, now I have this, and I can turn on that. If I select this and that, and I join stitches, now if I go to the simulator, view, shoe simulator, again that's a four in the studio.
You have to decide the order.
You need to design and join the stitches.
Okay.
And here it will save in all of these formats, many formats, and we save it in all formats. We center it in the hoop, and we save it as Anastasia, here, spiral, speaker, new. Okay. I will bring. I go to the folder that I made, so you can make your own folder inside the USB. And then I can go on the pages, because there are many pages. Here you have the afternoon circuits, all of these are circuits.
Ooh.
Spiral speaker. It's this one, yes. Mm-hmm. It will take 9 minutes. Okay. Here it says the needle number. Mm-hmm. So we can use the needle number one or the needle number two. Needle number two. Outside the file. Outside. Okay. Now we can use the... And this... arrows should look upwards. You cannot place it in another way. If you try to place it another way, then it will be more broken. And then you need to stiffen a lot with a better screwdriver. Normally,
what screwdriver?
No. Hello, Anna. Cool. Yes. Yeah, the thing is that we don't want this to be sewn either, no?
Mm-hmm.
We need to have it like that.
We're otherizing that we made the body. There was too much alcohol.
A part of that, we have to wait that the alcohol has to evaporate. All the alcohol.
No, yeah, but shouldn't be like that.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I tried and you... once you due di alcol e uno dice
el am muy bien y ahora
do this downstairs, no?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.